Hey everyone, in this video I'll be showing you how to post a list of JSON in PostgreSQL database with the help of Spring Boot. So let's get started. So I have already written the code for connecting the database as well as posting data, and if you want to watch the entire tutorial on that, you can just click on the card that is appearing on top, because in this video I'll be showing you only the post list operation. So before that, let me just explain you the code. So first of all, I'm having the entity class, which is called as person, and it has three data members, ID, name and email, and three corresponds to the columns in the table. And next one is going to be the repository, standard stuff over here, and I'm having the controller, and I've already done the operations, the CRUD operations by using them. So pretty much simple code, guys. And the post by list or ID is going to be exactly same like posting a particular object. The only thing is, here we will be passing a list of object. That's the only difference, okay? So just go to the controller and let's begin the code with our function public, and the return type is going to be list of person or list of object. So whatever the object that is getting inserted will be returned. It's going to be add list. That's going to be my function name. And here I'll be getting the list from postman, from postman's request. Okay, I'll be getting a list over here. So it's going to be at request body list of person, just a random name. You can have it as person list, that's fine. And inside this we'll be using our repo. It's going to be, the repository name is person repo, okay, the object of the repository, person repo dot, we'll be using the save all function. So for a single object we can use save, and for multiple objects it's going to be save all, and we'll be just passing the person list inside this. And we need to return, so we can just return this, that's it. So this basically will return the newly added objects from the postman, so this just returns that. So that's basically the code. And of course we need to add the path. It's going to be post mapping, and we can just have it as slash add all, something like this. And let me just run my program. So that's the code, guys. So now let's go to postman and do the remaining stuff. So I'll just copy the path, go to postman, change the path to post, have this http://localhost/8080, and here we will be having the path. Just add the path that you have specified in your code, and I'm running in port 8080. After that, go to body, it needs to be raw, change this to type JSON. And in my case, I'm going to put only two keys, which is going to be name and email, because because in my person model, here you can see I'm having three data members. One is ID, name and email. And the reason why I am passing only name and email here is because ID gets auto-generated. So that's the reason why I am not passing here ID in Postman. And now since we have started, the table will be here. So if I just now refresh this, yeah, the table is here, and we are having the columns and stuff. Now the table will be empty. So I will just go here and view. Yeah, the table is empty now. Once we post data, we'll be getting the values. So three columns, ID is auto-generated. We'll be passing only name and email. So I will go to postman. And first thing what you need to do is, you just need to enclose everything with a square bracket. Okay, enclose this. And inside that, have a curly bracket. And within that, you need to have your key, which is the variable that you have used in your column or in the data member. This variable should come here in your entity model. Okay, it comes here. This is the value, the other data member, the value within double quotes. If it's of type long or int, no need of double quotes, just the number. So now I'm just going to mock the values. I'm not going to be like so serious about the values. Comma separated, and you're just going to paste it multiple times. So just remove the last comma. So this is basically a list, and inside the list we are having multiple objects, so which in turn means list of objects. And we have skipped ID because ID is auto-generated. If ID is not auto-generated in your case, or if you have any other data member, you need to add it over here and send the value also. Alright, so now I will just click on send. Make sure that it's JSON over here. Send it. And we're getting the status as 200, which means that it's successful. And this is the response that I get. And the reason why we are getting the response is here because this return of save all. And that's the reason why we are getting the ID also, because it has posted it, and after posting the data, it has returned the newly posted values with the ID. As I told you, it's auto generated. And now I rerun the exact same query. Here you can see I'm having 5 values, and here also I have sent 5 objects, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this is basically how you post a list of object in PostgreSQL database with the help of Spring Boot. I hope you have found this video useful, guys. Do check the playlist of my channel. Done a lot of videos in programming and AI tools and other CRUD operations in Node.js, Spring Boot, PostgreSQL, MongoDB, MySQL, Gemini AI, OpenAI APIs and AI tools. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.